now it's time to, let's say, reset our relations. Because in the past year, there was a lot of negative messages coming from UK towards Bulgaria, and the response was, of course, quite negative. What was of concern for us and for many Bulgarians already working here, but also Bulgarians living in Bulgaria, is that some of those changes were grounded on the fears about Bulgarians and Romanians. So this is something that we should tackle, I believe, because it's not Bulgarians or Romanians that are the problem. It's a much bigger issue, much more complex, and from now on we should try to change the debate here in UK, but also the debate between us.
But on the flip side of that, some might say it's important to curb immigration into countries like the UK to protect the immigrants that are already there and are contributing to the system.
Well, I would say that UK companies have published 1.2 million vacancies in the European-wide system, which means that UK companies expect maybe 1.2 million people from now on to, maybe some of them will be UK citizens, but in principle they expect 1.2 million people to receive jobs in the UK. Which means that there is no matter of protection here, there is no need for fears. It is an open and flexible market, it should be. From that point of view, if somebody is needed here, should be able to come and take up responsibility.
Do you know how many Bulgarians have actually entered the UK asking for work since January the 1st? And you also know what the sentiment is like back home in Bulgaria, because presumably, as you alluded to before, the messages coming from the UK are not particularly welcoming.
Well, I have made a check with the air companies, for example, who are flying to UK, and already last year, and we saw that there is no difference in reservations, for example. So we do not have the statistics, but there is, in principle, there is nothing is changing in the number of people that are leaving Bulgaria towards UK, for example. As regards the number of Bulgarians who are already in the UK, we do not have precise statistics, but they're around 57,000, as we understand. And the level of employment of those people is higher than the level of employment of UK citizens, which means that the biggest majority of them are actually contributing to the welfare system more than they actually use.